Hello, my name's Fiona McIver, and I'm your presenter for this series of short videos explaining how to use the National Subcutaneous Insulin Chart. Although some of the videos in this series are directed specifically at prescribers or nurses, it's important that you view all of them sequentially to fully understand the chart. We've also provided a series of chart exercises that will allow you to check your understanding afterwards. Insulin is recognised internationally as a high alert or high risk medication in acute care settings. In response to this issue, the Australian Commission on Safety and Quality in Healthcare have developed the chart in collaboration with human factors researchers from the University of Queensland. The chart is a standardised national tool for the ordering and administration of insulin and for the recording of blood glucose levels, or BGLs. The application of human factors design to clinical charts has been shown to result in significant reductions in errors and improvements in clinical outcomes. In addition, standardising the communication of medical information between doctors, nurses and pharmacists can also reduce the harm to patients that might otherwise result from medication errors. For inpatients with diabetes, the National Subcutaneous Insulin Chart links together all of the key information required to manage the treatment of their condition. It has been designed to reflect best practice and promote consistent documentation to assist with accurate interpretation of blood glucose levels and subcutaneous insulin orders. This should enable clinical staff to care for these patients more effectively. For patients who aren't currently being treated with insulin, the chart is used primarily for BGL monitoring. Here is a filled-in example of the National Subcutaneous Insulin Chart. The chart can be broken down into four main areas. This area is used to record and monitor blood glucose levels. It provides prompts advising when a BGL should be acted upon if it is too low, for hypoglycemia, or if it is elevated, for hyperglycemia. These areas are used for prescribing insulin, specifically routine orders, supplemental orders, and stat or phone orders. This area is used to document insulin administration. Finally, these areas are used for additional communication amongst clinicians. The other videos in this series explain the mechanics of how to use the chart and include some rationales for the safety prompts and actions to be taken. Please note that they are not intended to provide diabetes management advice.